Hey now, people, this is Calvin here with the Boneyard TV show, and you're listening to Outdoor Adventures with Jason.
Killin' Sticks arrows are for the serious hunter, a company that understands the needs of the outdoorsman and provides five different styles of carbon fiber arrows, ranging from hunting to tournament arrows. If you want premium carbon fiber arrows, go to Killin' Sticks, KILLNSTIX.com, to review their carbon arrows. For listeners of the Outdoor Adventures with Jason show, use promo code OUTDOORS to get 10% off your first order. Killin' Sticks, where the blood trail begins. Welcome to Outdoor Adventures with Jason. Each week, I bring the world of hunting, fishing, and conservation to you. From the great hunting and fishing opportunities found in the Americas, to the dream safaris located on the dark continent beyond. I'll introduce you to those who are already out in the field living every outdoor enthusiast's dream, as well as outfitters and gear manufacturers that can make those dreams your reality. Welcome to this special episode of Outdoor Adventures with Jason. This is really cool. I've got Kelvin Buckler on the line. Kelvin, how are you doing?
I'm doing wonderful.
Now, I'm calling Kelvin right now. I'm down in Texas, but Kelvin is up in Alberta, Canada. And Kelvin and his partner, Jason Acorn, have a show called The Boneyard TV. It's making its premiere on internet television. Is that correct, Kelvin?
Yes, it is. Yeah, season 5, episode 1.
What should those of the listeners that are in the States, what should we expect?
Oh, I don't want to sound cliched, but it's real hunting. It's basically Jason and I hunting, guiding ourselves. And then we got, our buddies hunting with us, our pro staff or our team or crew, whatever you want to call us. We're a motley crew, but, and then we hunt in Alberta and public land, anybody can hunt it pretty much, Yeah, and then we take it out there. We definitely push the limits of having fun and hunting.
Sweet. Now, this is season 5, but for many people that are going to be here in the States, this will be their first exposure to you guys because you've been broadcasting up on Wild TV in Canada, correct?
Correct, yeah. We were 4 seasons on there, and we just decided to move on. It was just tough to deal with those networks, and then we just decided this is a better route. I think we can reach more people.
How are people best able to view your show? What's the website they'll want to go to?
TwistedOutdoorsTV.com. It'll be on there, and
I'll have a link to that in the show notes. So it's TwistedOutdoorsTV.com.
Yes.
And will it also be on the Boneyard's website?
There'll be a link there to Twisted, and then we're also going to put it on YouTube as well. And then we're going to load up all the old episodes as well onto there, just so you can kind of see where we came from. Because it's kind of neat to see it from season 1 to season 5, how it evolved into what it is. So, yeah, that's kind of the plan. But we barely got season 5 together. It's been a struggle.
Can you give us a hint on what this first episode, who's hunting what?
Well, I'm hunting whitetails in Alberta. I've got my bow and the old killing sticks, and I'm trying to be the first one of the season to get the killing sticks bloody. So, there's a bit of competition there, and it just shows me as I go through my season hunting whitetails, and it's a pretty good one.
I'm a member on your paid site on theboneyard.com. So I've had a chance to catch up on watching some of your past episodes. So I can tell anybody listening that these guys are fun to watch. It's good hunting. You're not going to be sitting there going, oh, here's the typical walk in on this animal, shoot it, pictures, rah, rah, rah. That's not what you see. You see hunting. You see these guys in a ground blind or up in a tree or just it's what the average hunter goes through. These guys are showing it like it takes place.
Yeah, we try to document it as best we can. Sometimes you miss stuff and everything else, and keeping the story flowing so the viewer can stay with you, is sometimes really difficult, but that's just part of it. And the filming, we've gotten way better at filming. That's part of it, too. It's just if you don't know how to frame a shot, it's unbelievable. You got to know how to frame a shot. And lots of it is Jason and I hunting solo as well. I filmed this, basically, all of it was myself. I filmed all of it. By myself, so everything, the kill shot, you name it.
Wow.
So it was I enjoy it. Then I can talk to myself and
The problem is if you start answering yourself.
Oh, yeah, then it looks bad. But, you know, after having the problems with the network and not being able to work out a deal, and then, you know, we've been waiting and waiting. Part of it is we have a hate mail segment, and we're animated puppets, Jason and I, and it's a pretty neat segment because we've had some terrible Facebook messages and emails from anti-hunters and hunters, which is blows my mind. But I get it. Not everybody likes your stuff. But my thought is turn the channel.
Exactly.
You know, and just... It's mind blowing. Like, if you don't like my song, shut it off. Like, you know, if I don't like a song on the radio, I shut it off. Some people just got to stand on their soapbox and beat you off, right? So we use some of that in our show just to have fun with it and show kind of people what we deal with. You know, not on a day to day basis, but depending on the post, you can get some pretty or the episode, you can get some pretty terrible things said about you.
Yeah,
but you put yourself out there and you will be judged, right? So
yeah, definitely when some of those love letters come rolling in, it's not what you thought you were going to get as a TV star.
Yeah, I wouldn't consider myself a star. I'm a hunter, and I just like to film my hunts. I've met rock stars with less ego than you know, a hunter that's killed a 180-inch deer. But I said that before, but it's just so true.
Yeah, no, I was being a little facetious there and goofing with you because I know your personality is very down to earth. There's no pretentiousness there about you at all. With the show coming out, you know, I'm looking forward to seeing this, and I'll have links all over my Facebook page and the show notes for this episode so people can find it. Tell me a little bit about Killing Sticks.
Well, Killing Sticks is a company Jason and I started, an arrow line started, and there is no Canadian arrow company because we want to, you know, support Canadian archers and American archers. Like, once we get bigger, you know, we want to be across North America for sure, and support the sport of, you know, archery, the tournaments and 3D and the hunting part of it, like, and keep that going, because I know it's a great thing for kids to get outdoors and be part of nature instead of just staring at their iPad, which is really... It's unbelievable how many kids are raised with an iPad.
Yeah, or, and it, again, it's the tool. It's the parents never taking that out of their hands.
Mm-hmm.
Never showing them, hey, look up. Quit looking just at the screen. Look up. There's a whole world around.
Yeah, exactly. So, and then we have Obsession Bows. We picked up them just in the last couple months. And I love, I'm shooting the K34, and man, it is such a sweet bow. I mean, all the high-end bows are good, but I do, you know, it's like when I first started playing guitar. For the first 3 years, I didn't really, couldn't tell the difference between, you know, as long as it stayed in tune. You play the guitar, it's fine, and then you pick up a Taylor, you know, or an Alvarez, or some, so, you know, a $5,000 guitar, and then you can just immediately, you know, feel the difference when you play it. And it's the same as a bow. You know, you shoot for 3-4 years and you think they're kind of all the same, and then once you pick up a nice bow, whether it's a Bowtech or a PSC or whatever, like, you know, some fit you better. You just know the feel. You just immediately, this is a nice bow, right? And that's what I love about the K34. They have the K cams. It's just a real, it's a beauty. And then who else do we got? Cam Clark Ford's been really good to us too. They're a local car dealership, and Sean Bell has just been amazing. And then the reason we got Obsession Bows is was through OC Archery. It's an archery range in Airdrie, Alberta. And Dane has been a real big supporter of us. He loves our show, and, you know, he thinks we're going places. So hopefully we don't prove him wrong.
There you go. And now Obsession Bows, I believe, is out of Georgia, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Georgia. Yeah.
So the stateside manufacturer. And I think, don't you also have a partnership? Who's your rifle firearms with?
Weatherby is our... Yeah, is our other one. And then Leupold is another one we partnered up with. Yeah, I mean, I've shot Leupold my whole life. That was easy.
Yeah, so all good stuff.
Yeah, you know, I've shot a lot of coyotes with my Leupold, you know, 3.5 by 10 power. I love that scope. And then the Bonehead Cam is another product of ours that we started. So we got a few there to promote.
So we're going to see Whitetail in the first episode. How many episodes in this first season?
I think there'll be 11 episodes.
And they're going to cover primarily all hunting in Alberta?
Yeah, there's one BC bear hunt, and with hounds, that was quite the experience. I don't know if I'd do it again, but just to go do it one time, it was quite the experience. And it's not that easy to tree a big bear. So, but we took a lot of slack over that one too, but still, it's just a different way of hunting them, right? So
it's, as long as it's legal, again, I say the same thing. When a hunter gives another hunter grief about what they're hunting or how they're hunting under legal methods, all it makes him is a hypocrite. We're all in this together. You know, your methods no better than my method, and my desires and wants for hunting are no better or worse than yours. So we're all in the same sandbox playing. Nobody's way is better or worse than anybody's else. And that just drives me nuts.
Yeah. it's pretty disheartening, but it's just life.
Well, Kelvin, I thank you for your time. Good luck on the show. I can't wait to hear how it goes. For the listeners, it's theboneyardtv.com is the website, and I'll have links to theboneyardtv.com in the show notes, to the channel that'll be broadcast on, as well as their YouTube channel, so that you can head out and catch them at any time. Again, we'll also send you over with links to Killin' Sticks, because it's really just a premium carbon fiber arrow. Kelvin, I thank you for your time tonight.
Right on. Thank you, Jason.
All right. Good luck and have a great night.
You too.